God is so very good to us, isn't he? Hallelujah. And my years on the mission field have been the greatest and most wonderful years of my life. I have never, ever considered it a sacrifice to be anywhere on the mission field, but rather just an investment of a life in the kingdom of God. And when you invest in your Heavenly Father's business, you cannot fail. He gives dividends of joy and peace and good things down here, and eternal dividends that will never pass away. God, praise the Lord. And I really appreciate the spirit of Pastor Lynn and Pastor Jeffrey, as they have had a real vision to reach the Northwest for Jesus. And it's been a step of faith and a big one. But God is with them, and we believe that God, what is sown in this place and whatever else God wants to do will continue and grow, and more people here in the Northwest will be touched by the power of God and really ministered to for God's glory. Well, you know, it's interesting to be a missionary because you have so many extra opportunities. I just say God kind of spoils his missionaries. And you know, I never dreamed that I would ever go very much further afield than to the far Northland. That was my calling. I was as happy as a clam at high tide up there. And everything was going good. I remember it many years ago. I was out on Monday morning with my skidoo just for a little jaunt out of the community just to kind of have a time to relax. And as I was out there, one time God spoke to me and said, I brought you in this land and I'll take you in and out of it and I'll send you to the nations. And I rebuked it. I said, no, this can't be God. And so I went on back to my home and to the church there, and I never told a soul. And I said, now look, God, this thing can't be of you, but if it happens to be, I'm going to ask you to just bring it to pass. I'm not going to do one thing about it. And do you know that within about a year, I started to get some invitations overseas. And so from that time, I not only spent most of my time in the Arctic, but I could spend the months when the people were out on the land and it was a good time to be gone, I'd go overseas. And it's exciting to see what God is doing all over the world. Doesn't matter where you go, you can find a pocket of revival somewhere. And you can find some countries like China and some of these that are moving in revival today in an unprecedented way. Oh, I'll tell you, I just get excited when I think about some of these places where God is doing such wonderful things. When you go to inland China, as I do, and work with the underground church, it's just like you're stepping into the book of Acts. Everything in the book of Acts you can see happening, even to the raising of the dead. God has done it again and again. And it's a tremendous thing to see what God does and how he does it. And to think that we have an opportunity to be a little part in the big program of God. Oh, what a thrill, what a delight, what a privilege, what an honor. Oh, let's thank Jesus for it. Hallelujah. We give you thanks, Lord. We thank you for the nations. We thank you for our privilege to serve you in any capacity. Hallelujah. I have been in the Arctic now about 53 years, and it's wonderful to see the mantle of leadership coming very heavily on many Inuit shoulders and on the next generation, and I'm sure on their children's children if Jesus tarries, because God, when it's put in the hands of the locals, it's going to last till Jesus comes. Hallelujah. And so we thank God for that, and we know it is his doing and it is marvelous in our eyes. Praise the Lord. Well, we've got to get into the word here tonight. You know, I could go on and tell you stories till midnight about mission field endeavors and the things that God has done, but we need to have some of the word. And so, Father, we ask for the anointing of the Holy Spirit upon your word tonight. We pray that you will quicken us and you will speak to everyone according to need, meet every need, bless everyone. In Jesus' name we pray, and everyone said,
amen.
Amen. Amen. By faith, well, this could take all that you need and then a little more to serve God in the capacity he wants you to, and to touch the souls and to reap the harvest in these last days. And then verse 10 of that same chapter says, but God has revealed them to us by his Spirit. Hallelujah. I'm glad God is revealing to us the truths of God's word today. And he's opening his word as he's opening the treasuries of heaven for his people, that they may be the overcoming church of Jesus Christ of the last day, proclaiming the truth of God, seeing the power of God revealed, and the glory of the Lord shining through.
Yeah.
Hallelujah.
Yeah.
Oh, God's doing it. It's for today. And I know there's lots for the tomorrows. And many people put many things off for the future. And I guess pie in the sky is okay. But I need some steak on the plate. I need something right now. I need more now in order to complete and the plan of God in our lives. You know, I remember many years when we were flying with our little aircraft. Sometimes we would take off with dark, dismal clouds all around us. But we just keep climbing. The pilot would just keep climbing, a little higher, a little higher, and then suddenly breakthrough.
Yeah.
And we break through those old clouds, and there the sun was always shining.
Always.
Oh, hallelujah. I'm glad breakthrough comes, and the sun is always shining, and God's promises are always true, and God's purposes cannot be frustrated, because what God has spoken, he will perform. Hallelujah. He's a covenant-keeping God. He's the God that cannot fail, and that's the God that we serve.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. You know, the sun was shining when we got above those clouds. It was always there. But the difference was we broke through. Hallelujah. We broke through those heavy clouds. And then we could experience the beauty of the sun and the warmth of the sunshine. Hallelujah. I'm convinced it's a time when we don't want to just hear. We want to experience God. We don't want to just hear about the glory. We want to experience the glory. We don't want to just talk about breakthrough. We want to have the fullness of breakthrough in this hour, that we can be filled with the fullness of God. Hallelujah. It's time. And so, you know, it really isn't the heavenlies that need to be broken through, because they're already wide open. It's us that need the breakthrough, to go through every personal barrier and hindrance so we can freely receive what God has prepared for us to make us effective in winning the world for Jesus in our generation. Hallelujah.